Welcome back to Tampa Bay Right Now. Joining me are Ashley Holly and Heather Patak, student coordinators from the Peace Volunteer Center at the University of Tampa. Welcome to the show, ladies.
Thank you.
So, Ashley, tell me about your work with Peace.
Well, our Peace Volunteer Center stands for People Exploring Active Community Experiences. We're a student-run organization. We host a different events of service events, campus events. Basically, Heather and myself, we coordinate a bunch of students, and we host just different events on campus, such as Locks of Love. We also do off-campus. We work with Metropolitan Ministries, Feeding America, different just events, service-oriented.
Okay, and how did you guys get involved?
Well, we've been involved for probably now three, four years.
Okay.
So we've worked our way up to student coordinators, which is a great accomplishment. But I actually got involved volunteering on an alternative break. So I actually signed up my freshman year to travel to Tennessee and work with the Cherokee Indians there. And from there, I was hooked ever since with Peace and volunteering and really being more involved at UT.
That's awesome. And what about you? How'd you get involved?
Same thing. I was really active my freshman year. I really enjoyed volunteering. I joined the Peace Club, which was kind of a sector of the Peace Volunteer Center. I got asked by one of the people that worked there if I wanted to be more involved and start coordinating events. Of course, I said yes, and from there I started being a volunteer coordinator and planning all these different off-campus events to the different nonprofits and then also our on-campus large-scale events.
So I know you mentioned Locks of Love. You mentioned, you know, going off to Tennessee. What are some of the other things that you guys do in the community?
Two of our larger events that we have each year is Into the Streets, which is a freshman orientation program. We basically have a setup where all the incoming freshmen volunteer during their orientation and get a little taste of Tampa. They get to visit a bunch of different nonprofits. It's a really great way to be involved very early in the stage. We also have our annual Dr. Martin Luther King Day Junior Day of Service, where we host the same kind of events. We have a lot more transfer students coming in during January, so it's a great way for them to get involved too.
Okay, and is this just for UT students, or is there other people that can get involved as well?
This right now is just for university faculty, staff, and then UT students.
Okay.
But we also like to engage the community. So we work with the nonprofits, we work with community members in promoting a variety of events or walks or anything like that. We like to say for the university, I like to tell students that there's never a weekend where there won't be a volunteer event going on at UT.
That's fantastic. And so there's just a plethora of events going on. You help multiple things in the community, yes?
Yes.
And so how do you get involved? If you are a Tampa student or a faculty member, where would you go to register? I know you said freshmen, when they register, are kind of encouraged to do this. But what about other people?
We direct everyone to our website,
okay.
And it's ut.edu/peace. But you can also sign up just by coming in to the Vaughn Center and as a student, just meeting with us and saying, we're really a resource.
Mm-hmm.
So we help students who will come in and say, I want to volunteer with animals, and setting them up with the Humane Society or setting them up with some other nonprofit in the area. So we're really a resource on campus, and just stopping in, saying hi, looking up different organizations that they want to work with is the best way.
And Ashley, what would you say to people who are like, I don't have time, I have a lot of schoolwork? Do you get that a lot? Like, oh, I just don't have time to volunteer? And what's your response to that?
Our volunteer events are pretty short. Usually the ones on campus are only about 1 to 2 hours, and our off-campus ones are only about 3 hours. But I always tell them it's a great experience. It's early. You could do it early Saturday morning. You can do it late Thursday afternoon. We have a lot of different time availabilities for students to volunteer, so it can always fit into their schedule. And volunteering looks great. When you leave the college, you have a bunch of volunteer hours, so it's good to get them in as early as possible.
And do either of you have any personal stories that maybe something you were affected by, you were volunteering, and maybe something impacted you?
I would say I specifically work with our Alternative Breaks program, which takes the university students outside of the Tampa Bay community, and we travel. So for me, it's really taking those students on those trips and bringing them back and having them say, wow, we affected a country or a different state. But then they come home and they say, now we can do that here.
Right.
So whether we're kayaking and doing coastal cleanup in Key West, they come back and say, hey, we want to volunteer with Tampa Bay Watch and kayak and do cleanups there. So that's what really hits home for me whenever they do that.
What about you, Ashley?
Great experience we've had with Carnival for Kids. We invite all local elementary schools to the University of Tampa for basically a fun, free day to hang out with college students and do Carnival games. We have a bounce house, cotton candy. It's always so great. We usually have about 50 students come out, and all the student organizations are also there. And it's always great for her to have that one kid who just loves playing in the bounce house and just has this one free day that they may have not had and had to do homework or sit inside or something. And it's moments like that that make it really worthwhile.
It's important, too, for them to have a role model for someone, you know, older than them that's in college that, you know, all little kids look up to. And, oh, I want to grow up really fast. But to have someone to look up to and say, wow, these people are helping the community, that's probably really important. Now, for these trips that you take for things that are sponsored, how do you guys get funding for this? Do you do fundraisers? Are there ways that other businesses can contact you and maybe help you out?
We will do some fundraisers specifically for the trips, but our budget comes from student government. So the fees from the university really help with what we're planning and how many students we get. And so we work on doing a really intense proposal for that every semester to get the funding.
That's great. So if you could tell people out there, why should I volunteer, what would be your sentence to them?
Why you should volunteer. A lot of times college students come into college not knowing what they want to do with their life. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times you leave college and you may not have that experience that you realize what you want to do. And I think volunteering helps that. Through the different nonprofits, you can work with elderly, you can work with children, you can work with animals. That will hopefully find your niche for the rest of your life. And we have a lot of people that leave that end up working with nonprofits. And I think that's a great way to start is if you don't really know what you want to do, maybe volunteering is the way to see.
Yeah, you can find out what you're passionate about and what really strikes a chord with you. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you both so much for being here and for being a positive influence in our community. Coming up next, we'll be talking with members from the Center for Leadership and Civic Engagement at USF. Stay right there.